Hello, my name's Donna Shea.
I moved to Bradenton from Massachusetts when I was two because my mom's brother lived down here.
My dad was the one that went to work. My mom stayed at home. She had a mental disorder that kept her homebound. And she was in and out of mental hospitals my whole growing up years. I remember as a child dropping her off and not knowing if she was ever going to come back. By the time I was 21, I got pregnant with my son. I had anxiety so bad that I stayed in my house. I would not leave. I didn't even want to go to the hospital to give birth. After about 3 years, I was able to control it. Of course, I picked up other habits. After I had my daughter, I became a medical assistant in orthopedics, and I was able to live a good life, still always having the anxiety in the background, but never going into panic attacks to the point where I had to isolate. In 2005, my dad got diagnosed with stage 4 colon cancer to the liver. He was terminally ill and was given 6 months to live. It just got to the point I was researching the cancer, and then I started to numb myself with pharmaceuticals. When that didn't work, it led to other drugs, which began to take me over. My dad ended up passing in December of 2009, where my life had just spiraled down. I ended up losing everything and living on the streets. My daughter went to her dad's, and my son went to his friends. They were kind of left to adult for themselves. I ended up coming to the bridge for food and clothing to try to get my life back together, where I met Tom. Tom took me into the food bank area and got me some food, and then took me over to the house and got me some clothes. He allowed us to sleep on the property in our car. I would wait till everybody left here and then pull in, because I was so embarrassed. But it was a safe place. And then one of our friends let us sleep on their carport. So I was asleep one night on the carport of my friend's house, and I felt something just kind of wake me up, and I heard a voice say, "You can do better than this, get up." That morning I signed myself in on a Marchman Act in Centerstone. I was scared, a little paranoid, and just at the end of my rope, God started to reveal himself in nature as I'm still homeless, walking my dog, and I would have sun beaming on my back. I went to an AA meeting, and someone recommended a recovery home, and they gave me the number to Tracy at His Girls Discipleship. I laid my 16 years relationship and my two dogs, and I left, and I went in the program. When I went in His Girls, I was all in. I was not looking back. There was nothing to look back that was any good. God has done amazing stuff in my life. I have been able to be free from anxiety, depression, any stronghold that has held me back from having a relationship with the Lord. I never thought I would be where I'm at.